Inflation shoots to 10.7%, fuel and food stuff, the main drivers. Central Bank reports increase in demand for agriculture loans. Charcoal scarcity pushes prices up. Troubled Kenya Airways defaults on $841 million loan. And outcry in Zanzibar as coconut prices rise. So, the conversation on inflation going up, sometimes when you look at it or when the Bureau of Statistics issues the report, the question is always, so what? But have you ever noticed that when the figures go up, it is actually those who earn less that are more affected? Well, this is how it works. So let's say you earn 200K per month and the inflation shoots. Now it's about 10.7%. That means, let's say you're buying a loaf of bread at, initially it was at about what, 3.5. If the inflation figure goes up, it means you have to pay an extra about 1,000 shillings on the same loaf of bread that you were buying at 3.5. So that will go to about 3.5, from 3.5 to 4.5. Whereas a guy that earns about 15 million might continue buying the same product, but will never actually feel the pinch of inflation, because at the end of the day, their spending power is just inelastic. They have the money and they can always buy things. What I'm trying to say is inflation is not good, but it affects the person that earns less more. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. From wherever you're watching, we're glad you could make time. This is what you can expect on the show tonight.
The biggest benefit that anybody has on their investment journey is time. So the amount of money is not the most important thing. To invest in a government bond, for example, costs or starts at 100,000 shillings.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, after government through the Uganda Revenue Authority in partnership with the IRA, that is the regulator, and of course the insurance industry, in July 1st, 2022, imposed a law mandating all cargo imported into Uganda by either sea, air, rail or road be insured locally. To insurance companies, this was seen as an opportunity to make some money, because then the imagination was that they'll be writing off all these other guys that are bringing goods, which wasn't the case in the past, because in the past, the importers could choose to write off from the country where they're bringing the goods from. But under the new law, you must write off with companies in the countries where your goods are destined to. Tonight, we speak to the Managing Director of Liberty General Insurance Uganda Limited on how this is changing the face of doing business and how their partnership with Multiline International is making it even easier for them to have more clients join as they bring in their goods. Views from the top.
Thank you for having me today. My name is Peter Mahanu. I'm the Managing Director of Liberty General Uganda. I think the sector has, we have seen some recovery from the pandemic, and we've started witnessing some growth in terms of premium. As of first half, we saw that the industry grew by around 18%, and that is a reflection of the resilience and sustainability that industry is going into. As regards Liberty, we saw our growth to reach 39%. That is from where we were. I'm looking at first half of the year. But up to third quarter, our growth has been at 57%, moving from position 9 last year to now position 5. As we talk now, I think the only thing we're seeing is the upside of claims, especially in motor and in medical insurance. And that is something that is concerning the whole industry in terms of the profitability. We're also seeing an upside of claims under the workmen's compensation, something that the industry is taking on through the UIA to see how we can risk manage this upside in claims. Something that is welcome as to us as an industry, because one thing is that our importers were either insuring offshore and or they were not insuring at all. And when the pronunciation of the Ministry of Finance in May, I think 2020, came in and 2022, and he said that marine will now be compulsory insured, I think it was a welcome thing for us as an industry. One is, I think it will be, the importers will now know who is insuring them, other than when it was those days when they would insure abroad. Number two is they'll have an opportunity to discuss their coverage with the local insurer. And then number three is when they have a claim, they will know who insured them and how to approach it. And if there's any issue, they have a regulator who they can run to just make sure that an insurer would pay their claim. The other thing we see is that there was a lot of money being sent offshore in form of premium, and part of it would be maybe the foreign currency that the country needs for other things. So the fact that this is now being insured locally, I think it will conserve our foreign currency, and it will also assist the insurance industry to develop and grow with the premium. It's important because they are investors and they have put in their money in terms of getting those goods so that they can do trade. And if there's no guarantee that if anything happens to the goods, say they are damaged while overseas or even on transit on road, and there's no person to run to compensate them when they are damaged, I think it will be taking them back to zero, because the investment will have been damaged. The other guarantee is that we have a regulator locally here who they can run to when the insurers maybe would want to dodge the claim, or there are issues that they would want to clarify with the regulator. So the regulator will be able to moderate in any issues that maybe the importers might be having with the insurer to make sure that the claim is paid amicably. One of the things we're doing is to make sure that we sensitize our customers, our clients, to make sure that they understand what the new requirement is and how they can purchase or access this insurance through a portal that has been jointly set up by URA, IRA and the UIA, to the extent that they understand how they can sign in and do all those things. But more importantly, what we are trying to show them, which most of them know, is the things that would require for them to do to get cover from that portal, is the commercial invoice, which will just be a declaration and the pricing of the goods that they are importing. Then the bill of lading, this will show where the goods are coming, where the goods are coming from, and the packaging and the type of goods, so that as an insurer we understand what we're covering. And then the other thing which is important also is the packaging list, which will show the goods that are maybe contained, that are in a container that we're insuring. I think that would make us as an underwriters understand the risk we are taking on, and how we should structure the coverage so that we don't give an inferior cover, as it were. One of the things that we did with the MART lines is just to see how together we can first socialize the new requirement to the clients of MART line. As you know, MART line is a clearing and forwarding company, and it deals with the most of the importers in Uganda. So one of the things we wanted is through them, we would want to see how we can, as an insurer, together with them, make sure that they understand the new requirements and how together we can assist them to achieve what is required. The other thing is that we looked at MART lines and the volume that they were getting to see how we can have the clients of MART lines benefit from the scale. I think that because they were giving us quite a sizable junk, we see whether we can give them some discounts so that it's a win-win situation, that the clients are well covered and they have very competitive rates and they understand what they are purchasing. We see a bright future in terms of us as an industry and us as Liberty growing that volume growing that volume of business of marine, because initially what was being insured out will be here now. And particularly our relationship with MART lines will make sure that all their clients are well covered, and if they have any issues, they would know where to go to when they have a claim, when they have something, to know what to do, especially on the coverage and all of. For us, I think it's important that one, they make sure that they protect their other earnings that they are using to import the goods by insuring. Number two is the directive that the Minister of Finance has come up with is so important that it will now make them be aware of who is insuring them. They can visit the insurance company to discuss the coverage, to understand the coverage. And whenever there is a claim, they'll know which office to go to and how to follow it through. So to me, I think it is so important that right now that the Minister of Finance, IRA and URA have come up with this initiative, it is good that they do the insurance for their cargo that they are bringing into the country.
Interesting conversation there, and sometimes maybe policies must be passed or laws must be put in place to ensure that, you know, if you force some things to happen, then the people that sometimes don't have the voice will benefit. Somehow, from that interview, the MD says they're finally seeing of some money coming through this, and which wasn't the case in the past, because in the past, like I said, most of these importers were dealing directly with the guys the other side of the countries where the goods were coming from. So we can only hope that as we end the year and get into a new year, you know, the insurance sector can pick up, and more so marine cargo insurance in particular. It is something that should drive our interest. You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Let's take a quick break. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us on our socials right below your screen. Tell us what you think, and we'll see you after the break. Stay with us.